one of the most novel inventions known to man, or to me, is the camera. Because with the camera we have the ability to capture moments and share memories. The camera is a very unique invention to me because something that happened long ago, the camera can capture that. In Psalms 139 and 14, lets us know, Brother James, that we are fearfully and wonderfully made. And one of the things that God gave us because we're fearfully and wonderfully made is a mind that has a camera. And we can bring back memories from things long ago, or bring back memories of things that have just happened. So today, briefly, as we celebrate our friend, our family, our colleague, Miss Gwen Coleman, we take glimpses and snapshots of this very fine woman of God. I want to briefly share a snapshot of her kindness and her pleasant demeanor. When you visited the Coleman home, as Cynthia and I often, we always left feeling better than we came. Crystal, we laughed inside the living room. We laughed around the house, and they were walking to the door. We just had such a pleasant experience. We loved the Colemans, and we felt better after that visit. As we honor and celebrate our friend, Miss Gwen Coleman, I take the snapshot of her being a consummate professional. A consummate professional. In our days, Agnes and Martha at Parkway Junior High, Miss Coleman was on top of the model. She was more than just a teacher. She was a facilitator of knowledge. And she wanted her children to get everything that she was giving out. And even in the program today, she had so many awards, but I remember she was named the Tennessee Education Association Distinguished Teacher Award, which is, President Boss, a very outstanding honor. A third snapshot is Gwen Coleman was a fierce but pleasant advocate. She did not want anybody to be treated wrong. In her own strong but pleasant way, she had us to know that Jerry, that's not supposed to be that way. And as I talked to Christians the other day, I thought, you know, with everything, you know, Miss Coleman would look within her calm way and say, Jerry, Mr. Woods, Dr. Woods, everything is going to be all right. So, with that in mind, camera, I know because others on the program, but this snapshot of such a detailed, professional lady, we thank God for her. And in 2 Samuel 9:1, these words, I think, are etched so very strongly today. And David said, is there yet any left in the house of Saul that I may show kindness for Jonathan's sake? And so I ask that question today. Yes, is there any left in the house of Coleman and Mary that we may show kindness in reciprocity for the sake of Gwendolyn Coleman? Yes, there are. Among all of us today, there are so many because we that he was among us, and we're all better because of it. And so this afternoon, in closing, may the God of Paul and Silas, may the God of Elijah and Elisha, may the God of Coretta and Mark, and may the God of James and Gwen Coleman, and may the God that James Weldon Johnson said, who bangs out in the lightning's flash, who claps his hands in the battle forward, and the God that sat down and shaped a piece of clay, and then into it he blew the breath of life, and man became a living soul. Amen.
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 Miss Margaret.
And for so many years, I called Gwen Mrs. Coleman because she taught all my children science at Parkway Junior High. I believe she shared her love of learning and science with her students, and she influenced so many teenage lives because they knew she cared about them each and every one. They could see her love in that sweet smile that she shared with them, and in all the many gifts of encouragement that she shared along the way. After 40 years of teaching, she retired and began coming to our Bible study and our women's study group. She loved to learn about our faith. What a joy it was for me to get to know her as my dear friend, Gwen. I love to listen to her insights in so many things about life, about our religion, and about our world. And we became afternoon movie theater buddies. And because we were both children at heart, we loved all the same movies, Disney and more. I always believe, and I do believe, that we have a heart connection because we would laugh at the same things and we'd tear up a bit at the same time. I can't explain in words what a blessing to my life my dear friend Gwen has been. I grew up in a big family. My father had six siblings, and I was the only girl in the whole generation, so I never had a sister. But I imagine that having a sister would have been like the loving relationship I shared with Gwendolyn Patricia. And I know she's in heaven watching over her family and all the rest of us, singing praise to the God we love. And I believe that Gwen is just a veil away, so we can and should continue our conversations and know that she will be listening and now watching over all of us who are still on this loving journey. James, Lynn, Crystal, Eric, all the family, please know that Chuck and I and all our family are holding you close to our hearts in our prayers. And we miss her, but we will see her again. I love you.
Take a mouse.
Talk about Ms. Gwendolyn Patricia Coleman without talking about the whole family.
I became a part of that family. I would have been lost at a moment or late catching up with my history that I love so much if I had not met the Coleman family. Put me on a journey to study my history forever and ever. It has made the greatest difference in my life. It will always be a part of my life because history is so important. And I have the glorious opportunity to get names from the Coleman family. Lost out there with no direction. Got started, I saw roots in 1977. It seemed like I was stuck from there. I said, what am I going to do? Because I have great interest in learning about my culture and my people. What am I going to do? Without any direction, without any warning, there was a new spark came into my life. Timothy Lacoba came into my life. Ms. Gwen came into my life. They actually taught me history. The history of my people. The history of myself. That's been over 35 years ago. They started an organization here that went on for over 30 years. And we all look forward to the African Street Festival, Juneteenth, Kwanzaa. The credit goes to the Coleman family. They brought it to us. They brought it to that. They brought it to me. And we still come along with it. We come along with the earth because we got down. And all the rest of them, Greg, Father Hand, carry on. Our children will carry on. And the Coleman family will be recognized. Bringing such great entertainment, knowledge, power to Jackson, Tennessee. We all love Miss Green. We can sit here and talk about all day. But we got other things to do. She will always be with us. Don't worry. Tell the kids that she's not gone. The spirit's here. They will always be here. And I say, amen. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Father, and all of the other worship leaders. I'm Pastor William E. Smart, Jr., and I am Mrs. Coleman's son-in-law, and I brought with me her grandkids, three of my kids, and my nephew, because I just wanted the generation to stand with me. I need their strength today. And I believe all love. That's just how we roll. You know, in the beginning, God said, let there be light, and there was light. The properties of light, there are either seven properties or 12 properties, depending on who you, what scientists you talk to. But there's two properties of light. Light is an initiator. We see that in the works of the sun, it initiates things. And light is a reflector. We see the reflection. A lot of times, it's not the true light, it's a subsidiary of light. In the spiritual realm, God is light. And we are reflections of that light. Coleman was a reflection of light, the light of the Lord. But there were times when she was not just a reflection, she was an initiator of light. She emboldened her students and enthused them to learn, and not just her students, but her children and her grandchildren. She empowered them through light. She passed light. And so she doesn't even pass it to her students, and to, but she passed it first to her family, the ability to understand life. She was a light. Light is knowledge. Yes. And she believed in the power of knowledge. She challenged us at all times to make sure you get the light and understand the capabilities and the possibilities of what
Coleman.
black church tradition. Now, I've been preaching for 53 years, so I have to say in this way that there's a, I learned in seminary from a seminary professor one time, there's a foolishness of preaching. And the foolishness is that you have the audacity to stand before people in the midst of their loved one that they are grieving over and tell them, you shall see them again if you die in the Lord. So this, as sad as we are, this, and thank you, Pastor Dr. Marks, for saying, you know, this is just a glimmer of how it's going to go when it's all
Bill Winston, and I spoke with the family. looked at me early on as I transitioned from Montgomery, Alabama to Jackson, Tennessee, and joined their faith community. She was one of the first to reach out to me. The Lord is really wonderful because He knew that I needed someone like her in my life at that particular time. She taught me about my race. She taught me about my faith. She taught me about Jackson in general. She was wonderful. She was a teacher. I was a student. I know I'm old, but I was a student. And she took me as she would one of her students in school. And she carefully molded me. She carefully taught me and cared for me in ways that she knew that I needed to know. And for that, I am most grateful to the family. Thank you for allowing her to be a part of not only my life, but so many others in this community. I thank you, and I thank her, and may God forever bless you.
Amen.
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 Thank you, Deacon Bill. Ms. Brenda Monroe Moses.
First, in mind of God, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
This is the head of my life, and I probably assume that He is of yours as well. I'm so grateful, so thankful, so blessed, so humble to be asked to participate.
Well,
it's such an auspicious occasion, this is. The homegoing, the celebration of Miss Gwendolyn Patricia Mary Coleman, a child of three, and so much more. That was just the beginning. Thank you, Sam.
Frustrated.
Catholic school for black children, she got her first taste in diversity. The teachers were white nuns. A year later, I started first grade at the newly built Washington Douglas Elementary, transferring 2 years later to the newly built Lincoln, both elementary schools part of the South strategy to avoid public school desegregation. New schools for Negroes. Didn't work out back then. The purpose was to impede or nullify the 1954 Brown versus Board of Education landmark decision that racially segregated schools were unconstitutional under the 14th Amendment, and integration must proceed. Our formative years set a path preparing us and so many others for a world different from that of all previous generations. We were destined to become participants in a more diverse American society. A decade later, we attended the story of that Mary High School, named to honor her grandfather a year after his death in 1922, where Pat made her mark in the class of 1963 as a personable, highly intelligent, gifted scholar. She was admired and respected by peers, faculty, and staff. Humility was her hallmark. Kindness and generosity made her so beautiful. Her remarkable adult life is like a beacon shining brightly as the loving and devoted wife of Mr. James Coleman. I was my husband. He knows where I've been. Cherished mother of four, doting ancestor to their descendants. You saw something there, you saw something there. Exemplary educator, invaluable mentor, civic leader, and daunting community activist and civil rights activist. Her impact, especially in the lives of youth, cannot be calculated except by our Heavenly Father. Most definitely, her life illustrates how a surrendered life to Jesus Christ, from an early age, committed to excellent serving glory, can sow and water seeds for a priceless harvest through God's increase, as you have and will hear today and going forward. Her work will speak for itself. Oh yes. There are some stars to be laid in her crown. As the last member of her family of arts descended from Mr. Elmer and Miss Bessie Alberta's spirit, her triumphant, victorious entrance into eternity is a reminder of how Elmer's father, Austin Raymond Leary, Madison County's first college graduate, prepared to do that kind of work in an embryonic school at Fisk University in Nashville, Tennessee, what it would become, and then became the first graduate from Madison County, graduated from Fisk University. I learned that from Pat when she came to our reunion in the library in the last place Mary High was located, East Campus, JCM, on the crowd, and she shared that with us. I did not know that. She told us the whole history of the Mary family in Mary High School, and all day regularly. Supported by his spouse, with their sacrificial personal financial investments, this legacy stretched across generations and racial lines. They created fundamental educational opportunities, not only during their lives and times, but for unborn generations of African Americans in particular, and others in Jackson, Tennessee. Their contributions have become a powerful
Good afternoon. Today we celebrate Ms. Coleman's life. Ms. Coleman impacted my life in so many ways. She blessed me with my friend Crystal, my best friend Crystal. We've been friends since we were 12 years old. She was my ninth grade biology teacher, and unbeknownst to me, preparing me for my college professor at the College of St. Louis. She was a cheerleading advisor at Park Road Junior High School, teaching me teamwork. She was a teacher who showed compassion for all her students. She was my example of professional demeanor. Her smile, her tone of voice, and I loved her facial expressions. To me, she was my example of educational excellence. Very stylish, confident, comfortable in her own skin. She taught me how to be a young lady. I'm so very grateful to have known and learned from Ms. Coleman. Ms. Coleman is my influencer.
And we just love every day
because we wanted to be right there to carry on what we could do at St. Joseph. And the priests, we had some of the best nuns and priests you could have. Not saying that you all are not.
Patients and
that days was street dedication and they were part of it. I don't think anything else, but as I said, this is one road. And she was my girl then, but she's, her name is changed now, because she's been a good girl, one that I never got, but I never wore a woman. And I just said that too loud, because some of them may just hear that. And there are lots of things that have not been mentioned, lots and lots. But as I say, I can be here for days and even weeks. So you don't have to clap for each other.
Some of you do, but most people have a really close connection. connection with their mother, because the mother is the person that brought them into this world. From the second you breathe life in your mother's womb, you had that connection with your mother, and you'll never lose that, even when your mother is absent from her body and present with the Lord. My mother was a woman of faith. She loved the Lord, and she loved the church. She loved St. Mary's and the St. Mary's community. I went to school, elementary school, right across the street here. My mother would drop us off in the morning, go to work, and come back. We were constantly looking down the road. Where's Mommy? What time is she going to get here? We'd all hop into the car. Just seeing these buildings and this campus is a reminder of many memories that, in the snapshots that we take, that you mentioned. I gotta say, the last couple of weeks, I think there's been a continuous flow of visual images. So many. And when I'm hearing these wonderful reflections and stories about my mother, I see those as well. I mean, these are things that touch your heart, and you'll always have these memories. My mom believed that if God can take you to it, he can take you through it. Yes, yes. She was full of hope, and you mentioned that earlier. And I think that mom was probably the most hopeful person that I've ever known. She was full of hope. Her name should have been. I mean, she had. She really believed in hope. Like you said, she had that inner strength. She had a very engaging personality. Even though her voice wasn't the loudest in the room, it wasn't the loudest. But for some reason, even here at church, if I lost sight of her and I looked across the church and I saw a congregation of people, more than likely I knew she was in that crowd of people talking to people. And as you said, she had a smile all the time. I'm even amazed at times. Because, there were times when she may not have necessarily felt like smiling, but she smiled. But she did feel like smiling most of the time. Because she was hopeful, she was optimistic. She saw the glass half filled when others may have just seen it half empty. She gave us hope. She was the spirit of our life. There's just so many things, as Ms. Duggan said, it's hard to condense all you want to say into a quick reflection, because there's just so many memories. One thing that was very true about her, and we found out very early, was that when we spoke to Mom, she was very engaging. She was fully present. She heard you. She connected with you. And she listened and heard. And you left that conversation feeling more uplifted and really good about yourself. And that she was in your corner. That's probably the part that I would miss the most. But I know the Spirit lives in us, in our hearts, in our memories, in our thoughts. And I know she's looking, she's looking down at everyone here. Some of you have come from far, further than other people, and some are local. And she appreciates that. She appreciates that. She really loved her family. She lost all of her siblings, but she constantly talked about her siblings. She had stories, and I haven't heard all of them. I'm constantly asking questions of family members. If I hear something, then I'll ask a question, a follow-up question, trying to just glean as much information about her experience and experiences in life. It's really overwhelming. I mean, she was our mother. Clearly, she had many roles. She was a facilitator of education. She taught for 40, 45 years. One of the most amazing things, and I thought, was I always felt that I played sort of the Robin role when I was home growing up. We'd go out in public, and I'd be in the mall, we'd be talking, and we'd talk to each other, and then I would start to scan the area, and then I would see a student or a group of students, and I'm like, oh, and they're coming over this way, and you know. So and I knew they were coming to say hello to my mom. I would assume that my position as Robin to her Batman, I would move over six inches and let her take the floor and just sort of wave and smile. And I remember just being filled up and so proud. I'm like, man, these people really love, they love talking to mom. You know, to mom, she had that appeal. It was amazing. I'll never forget that. And even this week, you know, to hear stories from our neighbors who, you know, they've been so kind and generous. They came by, a neighbor came by with their son, and the son said, you know, your mom taught me. And then all of a sudden the son says, oh, and she taught me too. The son is bigger than the father. And I'm like, that's pretty amazing. They both had a smile on their face. They were like, yeah, that was my Miss Coleman.
From her experiences and from her life and what she read, what she learned.
She lived the educator's life. I mean, just because she had taught for 40 years, she felt like, I have more to learn. I will never stop learning. I will continue to read. I will continue to learn. I will continue to speak to people who know more than I do on a particular subject. It could be any subject. She was remarkable in that way. She really was. But I think the most joy she had was when we were all at home, the entire family. We tried to be home more often. It didn't always happen, but when we were, you could tell that she knew that all of her kids were home at the same time. And if three of us were home, that fourth one that arrived got most of the glory, because
before we go our separate ways, we take leave of our sister. May our farewells. One day, we shall joyfully greet her again.